I'm Aldi Keen, this is Matt Braun. We're here to talk about positioning, a new video series offered by the LRC. Positioning, how can you determine your position in the marketplace? What are the implications of that position? What decisions can you make? Matt, this is an absolutely vital topic for most organizations, all organizations. And we've seen some cases in our recent programs where companies have made decisions to sell to the wrong customer, to try to change the wrong customer, and by extension, not focusing their resources on the right customers and getting the love from those customers that they should be. You have some experience in that.
Yeah, it's a difficult conversation that a lot of organizations are having, whether you're in the B2B space, the B2C space, or we even see it in the association space, the nonprofit space. See, this whole conversation around good fit customers and bad fit customers, and that's at the center of this discussion around positioning. When we talk about bad fit customers, you look at experiences or decisions that you've made where maybe you're trying to push more and more communications out to these customers and they're not responding. Well, is it because you're trying to sell them something or make them aware of something that's irrelevant? It's not something they need or something that they want. We've seen some instances where organizations are expanding their product lines or their service lines. They're creating extensions, just trying to make their customers happy, more satisfied. Well, what they end up with 2 or 3 years down the road is just an expansive, way too big of a product portfolio or solution portfolio. You've basically become all things to all customers. And then finally, you think about the time that your account managers, sales teams, or customer service reps are spending trying to retain these bad fit customers. You know, in any of those three examples, you're running up a significant amount of cost for your organization that you may not be able to counterbalance with the revenue that those bad fit customers ultimately bring in.
Matt, we've looked at customer profitability compared to fit, and we see in a lot of these cases, bad fit customers, you lose money on them. And those financial losses, those direct financial losses, don't capture all the losses. It's the opportunity cost of not spending the time on the right customer that will respond to it.
Right.
So as you said, most of the time you think of this as a B2C tool, but we've seen it be unbelievably effective in B2B and associations. Tell me, what are we going to cover then in this video?
Yeah, there's going to be a number of videos in this series. We're first going to look at how customers make decisions as to which organization to do business with. What are the needs that they have, the decision criteria that they have, not only in terms of the types of product and service, but various levels of product and service. We're then going to create or describe different segments that exist in the market. We're going to size those segments and profile those segments, but also talk about how you can take that information and extrapolate it onto your customer population, really help with your messaging strategies out to the market. We'll look at the relative position of each of those segments compared to not only your organization, but also competition in your market. And then we'll talk about the implications of that position. How do you change it? What is it going to take? Is it a design issue, an execution issue, or a messaging issue? And that will be where we'll wrap up. Now, we'll tie this back to a case study that we've been working on over the last 12 to 18 months, a very relevant B2B or B2C case study, and we'll put it in the context of that particular example.
That's great. So the main takeaway is you've got a market. That market dictates your positions available. Well, what you can do. You then design your business model, you execute against it, you communicate, and that establishes how successful you are. So a great tool, a great aspect that should be in your arsenal for making decisions. So look forward to getting into this video series with the very first video on customer needs and segmentation.